In the past, I have explored the role of imaginal cells in what is called metamorphosis. And the whole question of memory retention. So let's talk about this a little bit because I want to revisit it with a new idea. So, imaginal cells are the building blocks of flying insects. They're essential to the dramatic transformation that occurs during metamorphosis in flying insects, like butterflies, for example. They are clusters of undifferentiated cells present within the larva that lay dormant until the pupal stage. Think of imaginal cells as seeds, each destined to form a specific part of the adult insect. During metamorphosis, guided by hormonal signals, these imaginal cells proliferate and differentiate into the various stages and structures of the adult flying insect as follows: wings, legs, antenna, complex eyes, reproductive organs. In many cases, imaginal cells completely replace larval tissues. During the pupal stage, most larval cells are broken down, providing resources for the imaginal cells to construct the adult body. Do the butterfly or flying insects retain memory of their experiences as the insect, the non-flying insect, the caterpillar? This is where things get fascinating and actually quite complex. The extent to which memories of a caterpillar experience are retained in the adult insect is something that is now a subject of research. Structural changes. This is what we know. Structural changes. The insect's brain undergoes significant reorganization during metamorphosis. This means that the neural networks that stored memories as a caterpillar are likely to be altered. Studies on moths and butterflies suggest that some learned associations from the caterpillar stage can be retained into adulthood. For example, caterpillars trained to avoid certain odors may demonstrate this aversion as adult moths. So, what's going on? Okay, what's going on? Scientists do have explanations. Some say that specific neural networks are crucial to learn behaviors and may be preserved during the reorganization. Others suggest that hormonal signaling plays a role, and it may be how memories are retained during different stages. Anyway, the key points are: imaginal cells are the fundamental drivers of the physical transformation of a flying insect during metamorphosis. Memories, the way we think of them, may be retained from the caterpillar's experiences. Now, is there any explanation from genetics? Do random mutations and natural selection explain this phenomenon? So, mutations are changes in the DNA of an organism, and these can happen during cell division due to environmental factors like radiation and many other factors. So imagine an insect ancestor with a simpler life cycle. A mutation arises that creates a stage where the insect can focus only on eating and growing like a larva. This allows it to reach a larger size before reproducing. Another mutation creates a pupal stage where the insect undergoes a dramatic transformation to develop wings for flight and reproduction as an adult. These mutations would be beneficial to survival and reproduction. Over generations, natural selection would favor these mutations, leading to the prevalence of complete metamorphosis in flying insects. What are the genetic and epigenetic mechanisms behind this? The specific genes that control metamorphosis are complex and are still being studied. However, we know that certain genes regulate things like molting, cell differentiation, development of adult features like wings. Epigenetics also likely plays a role. Epigenetics refers to the changes in gene expression that don't alter the DNA itself. These changes can be influenced by the environment, can be passed down to the offspring, further influencing the developmental process. So this is the scientific explanation so far. But remember that the scientific explanation is the explanation of the scientific mind, which is a modified form, or say a conditioned aspect, of non-local consciousness, if you believe that consciousness is the ontological primitive, and that genes and epigenetics and random mutations are very good physicalist explanations, but they are symbolic representations of a creative process in consciousness. Even randomness or unpredictability is suggestive of creativity. So, taking this example, I have to ask you a question. Are you and I the imaginal cells of non-local consciousness awareness? Are we, you and I, the imaginal cells of infinite, unbounded consciousness evolving as a creative process in a never-ending horizon? Are we the imagination of the cosmos? Please comment if you agree or disagree. Are we the imagination of the universe?